welcome admitted students. So whether you've confirmed or not, hopefully this will give you a good guide of some things to expect with the program. All right, so as Rebecca mentioned, you know, B Boulder is kind of the thing around here, but we also have within our program the B Mechanical Engineering type of subfield with that. So one of the few things that I'll focus on in our little segment today will be our coursework, the design center facilities with our makerspaces, talking about our faculty as well as experience that students can enjoy, whether that's local, international, but either way, well-rounded experiences, as well as our major's specific focus on professional development. So this next slide here is a copy of our flowchart. So we have, you know, kind of running jokes about this because there's just so much when it comes to this flowchart that so many arrows, so many boxes, all this stuff. But this is a snapshot of everything that you would be completing within your, you know, your years at CU Boulder completing the mechanical engineering program. So this is broken up into 8 semesters, but you know, however long it takes to finish. And it breaks down semester by semester what classes to expect. So one thing that we make sure to mention to all students is maybe 98% of students really don't follow this plan to a T. And you know, you meet with an advisor. So there's 4 of us on the team. A few of us are in this presentation as well. And we work with you individually. Every semester we meet with you to come up with a personalized plan that works for you and gears towards what you want to accomplish out of this degree program before you graduate. And so one highlight that we have is our design coursework. So we have a first year projects class. So within your first year, we have you dedicated to a class that deals with having no engineering prior knowledge at all and kind of throws you in there so that you and a team work on designing something on your own. I mean, of course, for that to be your first year, or your first time in the engineering experience, there is a little bit more guidance than just throwing you in completely. But that is one thing that students really enjoy. I mean, obviously, you know, many students choose the engineering programs because of the hands-on facets that the curriculum can provide. We also have a computer-aided design class and fabrication. So from that class, you learn SolidWorks. At the end of the class, you take the certification exam to get certified in SolidWorks. And you also have a final project where you actually work with some of the machine shop spaces on campus to actually, you know, craft something using the SolidWorks program. And then in component design, you are working with a building, with a team on building a drill powered bike together, and you compete in a runoff, which we will have a video of later on in this little segment. We also have a year long senior design project. So it's a 2 semester sequence class. And in that class, we currently have two sections of it, which one section is industry sponsored. So actually a company does sponsor some of our teams to essentially contract our teams to build and work on a year-long project for something for their company. So you get a lot of real-world experience working with clients in that way. We also have another section of that class that's the engineering for social innovation section. So in that class, the teams are devoted towards building something that impacts the society in a positive, greater way. I mean, obviously we are working with limitations of it being an academic year-long program or a year-long project. But some of the ideas that come out of that are really awesome. But that is a little bit more like an entrepreneurial or Kickstarter based type of project as well. And then we also have technical electives. So on here, the link is provided, which I accidentally sent you all earlier, which is a list of the technical electives that are mechanical engineering specific taught by our faculty, but at the same time also allow some more hands-on work to happen there. So we have a video here, just because we have limited time. The link is here if this video actually does not work for you, but I'm gonna leave that to for you all to watch on your own time. Because I think that this video instead actually doesn't work for everybody. It's only about 20 seconds long, so I'm just gonna play it. This is a video clip from our mechatronics and robotics class. There's a competition that happens at the end of the semester to actually showcase what the students have worked on. So in that class, students are building autonomous robots, and that's the theme of that semester was Rocket League. If any of you all play that video game, these are autonomous robots that are built to be in a Rocket League type competition. Anyway, fun times. I really can't get audience background here. So hopefully you all enjoyed that video. But you know, those are all of the students who are in that class, all looking to see who's gonna win that competition at the end of the day. All right, so one thing I mentioned was our robust faculty. So since mechanical engineering is such an interdisciplinary program as it is, we have faculty who range from all different types of research areas. So we've got air quality, biomedical, material science, mechanics of material, micro nanoscale, robotics and systems design, and thermofluid sciences. So, I mean, one of the big draws of mechanical engineering as it is that it is such a broad area where, you know, students graduating from this program can move into so many different facets of what they want to do with their career later on. And we do have a more specifically guided class in our curriculum that helps students hone in on those specific subfields as well. We also have some robust research opportunities for students. So I've added some links on here where, you know, there is the Discovery Learning Apprenticeships program where students can get paid essentially to be involved in research. There's also the opportunity to work as a lab assistant, working with any of our faculty, whether that's within our department or outside of our department. There's a lot of research out there that requires mechanical engineering support, even if those are, you know, faculty from computer science or electrical engineering, things like that. There are also independent study options. So that means you and a faculty member actually decide and create or craft a class of your own where you are honing in on specific research areas or your own specific area or things that you want to study. And usually it is based off of the expertise of that faculty member as well. And that way you can earn credit for, you know, being able to target exactly what you want to get out of the program and through that independent study. We also have the Bachelor's Accelerated Master's Program, the BAM program, which allows you to essentially overlap two classes between your bachelor's and your master's before you graduate and then transition into the master's program by itself. So it's kind of a nice stepping stone and allows students to more easily streamline between one program to the next. And yeah, more information on that link right there. There are also many ways to get involved in the CU Boulder campus community or the engineering community or the mechanical engineering community. So ASME is the American Society for Mechanical Engineers. So there is a chapter that is at CU Boulder. And so there's a lot of activities and events that the student board hosts. Things like Pi Day, where students get to pie instructors in the face. And there's also professor dinners, as well as happy hours that community puts together and hosts just to kind of build more relationships between different engineering students. There's so many other opportunities on here listed as well where CU Boulder has, you know, a chapter that's dedicated to that specific subgroup that you might want to join. And then we also have lots of ways to develop you all professionally. So like I mentioned before, we have a class, it is our MCEN 2000 class, which is a professionalism seminar class. So in that course, you would learn about resume writing, cover letters, interviewing skills, as well as just, you know, exploring the career of being a mechanical engineer in the future. There's so many different ways. And when our students graduate, there's so many different types of industry where they move into later on that, you know, we just want you to kind of see a full gamut of what's actually available and at your fingertips later on. So we have a robust alumni network where, you know, a lot of our alumni will actually come back and volunteer to do mock interviews with students, with current students. There's a lot of ways to, you know, do more career exploration. So Emily, who is on the call as well, she's actually one of our upperclassmen in the program, and she's one of our student apprentices, which means that she has drop-in hours, and we'll talk about that in a couple slides, where she does career check-ins essentially with students who are looking for internships, or, you know, for students who are kind of looking for something past CU Boulder at that point as well. And then there are, we also have a professional development advisor, Kat McConnell, and she helps with job searches and, you know, LinkedIn development and preparing for interviews and all that good stuff. And then we have a design your career program, which is on top of the curriculum for our major, which essentially guides students through the process of learning what it is to be a mechanical engineer. So in your first year, you attend a dinner where we bring in alumni and upperclassmen to talk to our first year students about what you know, mechanical engineering has done for them as they've, you know, graduated and moved on to bigger, better things in their lives. And then we also have in your second year, essentially a field trip where we have partnered with different companies in the local area where you actually go and with a number of other students in the program to tour an engineering facility and see what it looks like to be a mechanical engineer day to day. So on this next slide is just kind of a recap of a lot of the things that we've talked about already. But this has obviously the most robust number of links in here. The main point, you know, the guiding principle for our program is that our students do engineering. So that means, you know, whether that's learning more specifically about design and fabrication, there are so many machine shop spaces on campus. You know, the senior design class has its own dedicated area in our Idea Forge, which is, you know, a separate building that's a little bit more connected to more of the machine shop spaces that are available for engineering students. We also dedicate our classes towards creating curriculum that's a little bit more active, more meaningful, and definitely more hands-on. And then we also have very accessible faculty. You know, the advisor's offices are actually in the same wing as a number of the faculty in our program. And so that allows us to connect you all with instructors for office hours and things like that, or also just to, you know, clarify questions that you might have. And we also, you know, have so many different opportunities for student involvement. So that's where that collaborate link is going to lead you to. And then the professional skills, which I mentioned before. So on top of just the experiences beyond just curriculum, there's just so many different opportunities for students to hone in on and gain more experience with curriculum that, you know, kind of expands beyond just the typical coursework. So our program has, you know, one of the most options in terms of study abroad in the engineering college. So we have students who go to Australia, which I think that's where Emily went, and she could potentially share her experience with that a little bit later on. Spain, Germany, England, Ireland, and so on and so forth. So more information in that study abroad link right there. We also have options that are built into our curriculum, so students can choose to do more biomedically or environmentally based courses in their as their tech electives later on. And we also have the room for students to be able to pursue additional minors outside of just the mechanical engineering program. And then, like I mentioned, there's the bachelor's accelerated master's program. And so if there are any additional questions, sorry, I didn't leave, I only left like 3 minutes, but we actually do have drop-in hours tomorrow. And I am going to have to clean this up because I forgot to add the Zoom links. But on Wednesday and Thursday, we do have student apprentices, which are essentially upperclassmen in our program, who are going to be available during in those Zoom links. To be able to answer more specific questions. So potentially, you know, you take a closer look at the links on the slide and you can ask more specifically pointed questions during that space and time. All right, but other than that, I'm gonna try to open it up to questions right now.